Hello. Thank you, each one of you, for coming and sharing your time with us here at Pensacon. I'm sure everybody appreciates that. I wanted to touch on the video game. Before I saw the movie, the TRON video games were, we'd go into the arcade, they were side by side, wall to wall. I've never seen a video game that had so many that fill up arcades in my life. And then playing that game, I was like, wow, this is so cool, and I went and saw the movie. If y'all have any knowledge of the marketing and what went into that and behind that, I'd like to hear you share a little bit of that.
They don't touch base with us about marketing, really.
No.
We hear it after the fact. But that probably was a Bally's game, wasn't it?
It was Bally, yeah. And then there were the discs of Tron. You literally had to get down inside of it. I never saw that game before. The one thing on Legacy, when they recreated the interior of Flynn's Arcade, it was amazing. I want to tell you, Cindy, I walked in there and I thought, oh my God, we're back in Culver City. It was to the teeth. And they had scoured the world for those arcade games. And most of them were in absolute mint condition. And I kept looking up at where Flynn's office was, and I really expected the blinds to go up and Jeff looking out over. Young Jeff. But they really went through a lot of trouble with that detail. The marketing, no, I'm... How many games were there, do we know?
I think there was like 65.
Really, of arcade-type games?
Because
we have the video game.
Well, video games like video game systems. Yeah, I think there was only one arcade game or something.
I did the voice work on most of them. Well, the Kingdom Hearts. It's the first time my youngest son thought I was ever cool.
And left.
And I was with Daffy Duck.
Thank you.
Well, they told me I'm the last one, and I actually didn't have a question. I just wanted to thank you guys. The work you guys did 38 years ago has created so many memories for us that we're celebrating it today. And I just want to give you guys a round of applause.
We are unfortunately out of time. However, if you haven't gotten your fulfill of Tron, we are showing the movie right after this. So if you would like to stay for a special screening of Tron, please do. I would like to thank again our guests, David Warner, Bruce Boxleitner, Dan Shore, and Cindy Morgan, once again for coming down to Pensacola and giving us this wonderful presentation.